It's now time for Ask the Expert. It seems like every week there's a new dating app or a site promising the perfect match. But for many, liking, messaging, swiping to the left, to the right becomes overwhelming and often just discouraging.
So what's the best way to get over swipe fatigue and still get a date? Local professional matchmaker Julie Amon from It's Just Lunch is here to explain. Can you explain this swipe fatigue for us?
Well, I will tell you this, it is here to stay.
Is it?
Because people are so busy. Clients are telling me all the time that between work and working out and just their social obligations that they're having a hard time finding those opportunities to meet great singles. Okay. So going online, going to these dating apps, it really is just so easy. The problem lies in the fact that you're often making this really quick snap decision about a person, and it becomes a game, and often a really impersonal, frustrating game. So there are singles everywhere, amazing, eligible singles. I talk with them every day. Mm-hmm. And you just have to be open to it. You also have to be giving out the right kind of signals.
So let's talk about that, signals, because you're swiping this way, you're swiping that way, but how do you then become open and approachable for someone to walk up to you to have that moment, the missed moment that you read about in the newspaper?
I have a few suggestions, and the first is going to seem simple, but it's so important. You gotta be positive. When I'm talking with singles, it's the number one attribute that they're looking for. So how do you display that? It's really simple, smile. Look friendly. If you look more approachable, if you make eye contact with someone, you're more likely to be approached, and that's no matter where you are. The other thing you have to do, you've got to disconnect if you want to connect. And you gotta put your phone down, right? We've all been in that situation.
Stop swiping for a minute.
Stop it, be connected. Look at those around you. Okay. And you have to pay attention, right? We've been in that moment where somebody practically bumps into you and they barely look up from their phone. You are missing opportunities to meet someone that you may have a real connection with, if that's the case.
All right, so you make that connection. How do you keep the conversation going and sort of saying, you know what? I'd like to see you again.
This is where people will say, I should have reached out, I should have said something.
Do I get the number, do I give the number?
Yes, and you know what?
I remember from those things.
You do, you do, and it is still, it's still the issue, right? But you have to go out on a limb. No risk, no relationship is what they say. And find that common interest, find that common ground. For instance, if you are at a grocery store and you are shopping the wine aisle and you look at someone and it's someone that you're interested in, it may be as simple as saying, I always buy the same kind. Do you recommend that? Or I gotta think outside of the box here. You gotta open up the door. The biggest
advice.
Is this
most for men?
I would say it goes both ways.
Oh,
it really,
really
does. Number one advice, be genuine. If you think you have a smooth pickup line, probably not gonna work. People want sincerity, and keep that door open. If you're comfortable giving out your number, great. If not, suggest a common meeting place, somewhere where you can meet together.
Always good advice.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you for coming here. All right, got a question for our experts. Email them at asktheexpert@todaystmj4.com. You can also leave a voicemail. The number is right there for you.